Hey everyone, it's Wingspan TT, and if you're watching, you know what time it is. It's time for Mass Effect 3. Yes, we're just going to play the new Mass Effect 3 demo. It just came out, and it has blood, sang, partial nudity, Oh wait, those are the same things, only one's in French. All right, it just came out on Xbox Live, on PC, on not on PlayStation. I don't know why it's not on PlayStation 3 yet, but you can only get on PC and Xbox 360. And I was just put it on my Xbox because I was able to start downloading early. I don't know, it's just easy to do. So let's just go in here, and right off the bat, I'm spamming the A button, the B button, the right trigger, but I gotta commend BioWare, because this is the first game I played in 5 years where it says press start, and I think I actually had to press, I actually had to press the start button. I think, look, X, what, there, yes, there you go, start is the only button that works. So BioWare, right off the bat, 9 out of 10. And, oh god, Origin. Alright, fine, I need an Origin account. Yeah, I have one, whatever. And we see there's some kind of space laser. My Assassin's Creed thing is going to stop downloading, so none of that. I guess I could read these terms of service and figure out exactly how my private information is going to get sold to third parties. But, whatever, I trust Electronic Arts isn't going to do anything with my personal information that could get them personal gain or profit. So, I just feel that they're a company that can be trusted with unlimited privacy information, so I'm just gonna, I don't need to read those documents or anything like that. Just gonna jump right into the game whenever Origin decides we're gonna play it. And right now we see the interface is very similar to Mass Effect 2, similar enough that it feels kind of lazy, honestly. We got multiplayer news here. Do you want to play Mass Effect multiplayer sooner than Friday the 17th? Yeah, of course. Of course I do. You know, why do I even want to play single player? Am I gonna just, are there just going to be spoilers in this? Am I going to find out that Shepard dies at the end? Just like that guy at E3 told me that don't tell anyone on your channel, but Shepard's going to die because it's like an analogy, because he's like the good shepherd and, you know, Jesus and all that stuff. So I don't know if it's going to be like that, or I don't know what's going to be in the single player, but whatever it is, I guess I'm just going to play it. I'm going to play it for you, all right? So if there's spoilers in here, if I learn things I didn't want to learn, it's just, remember, it's your fault, okay? You, the viewer, it's your fault. So let's see here. What is this? What? All conversations? Yeah, duh. What? There's a no decisions mode? Is this for real? You can now play Mass Effect without making conversation decisions. Apparently, for some people out there, it was too hard to choose whether you wanted to have sex with Liara or not have sex with Liara. Like, I don't understand. Like, was it really that difficult? I guess everyone just wants to, you want to have, and look at this, VO language, you can't change it from English, alright? Even though they're fine to warn you about the sex and nudity and blood in French, right? But you can't choose French as a language? Like, if I were French, which every day I pray I was, but if I were French, I'd be very, very, very upset with that, alright? I would write a very stern letter to the people of BioWare and let them know that that is not cool, alright? That is not cool. Alright, this is the only graphic settings. Change the brightness. Alright, why do they even say graphics if there's only one graphic setting? Shouldn't it say brightness? Alright, upload gameplay feedback. Nope, I don't want you needing to know what I'm doing, EA, because then you're gonna know I'm spending way too much time in the character editor, and that's just fucking embarrassing. Alright. Connect. What? Okay, this doesn't do anything. Just connects you to Cerberus. I guess not Cerberus anymore. Alright, let's just start. Male, female. Everyone knows the Shepherd is female, so there's really no choice. We're just going to jump into this. Take Earth back. I see. So, this game comes out in, what, 3 weeks? Why did they release this demo? I don't get why they released this demo. Everyone was going to buy this game anyway. I was going to buy it. I was going to give no critical thought to it whatsoever and just slam my $60 on the counter and say, Walmart man, give me the Mass Effect. And he was going to go, excuse me, I'm a woman? And secondly, I don't know what Mass Effect is. So, okay, I see here. So they kind of changed it now. There's like, role-playing is you control everything. The traditional Mass Effect experience. Action, I guess, is you just control the action. It does the dialogue for you. And story is you control all the dialogue and action is super easy. So that sounds like pussy mode. First one sounds like meathead mode. I guess we need to have a realistic name. I always like to role play Mass Effect, so I like to put my real name in here and just get into character. You know, just say, like, when the characters are talking to me, I want to think it's me. So I'm Wingspan Shepherd. I hit the B button by mistake. How do you move forward? Hit start. Good. Wingspan Shepherd. like to role play. I mean, okay, maybe I don't like to role play, so I'm playing as a girl. My goal here with creating the female characters is really always twofold, all right? On the first part of it, it needs to look enough like my wife that when she's watching me play the game, she's not like, oh, why did you make her look like that? Is that how you want me to look? All right, so it needs to look kind of like her. So, I mean, this kind of haircut, we'll get, you know, her chin is just a lot. No, nothing like this. And then it needs to look different enough from my wife that, you know, I can just have her get massacred and not feel too bad about it, you know? The first game, oh, God, I just spent way too much time crying in that game after watching the love of my life, just get, like, murdered over and over by the Geth. It was just really sad. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, her lips are just like that. Yeah, oh, just a little wider. No, that's not right. Let's see. Yeah, all right. Anyway, enough about my personal life. I love how there's a code at the bottom. See that? Look at that. It shows you. So now when you're watching these videos, you know, when you're watching YouTube videos and you want to say, like, I want to make Wingspan TT's wife as my character. Now it's no longer a secret. You can just look at the code at the bottom and copy it, and you'll be able to just make the exact same character. So when someone, like, they make Keanu Reeves in this game, or, you know, they remake all the characters from Community and Mass Effect, and you want to know how they did it, you could just watch their YouTube video and copy that code. So just so you know, in the future, I'm going to be messing with this a lot, and for the purpose of my viewers' integrity, I'm going to be blanking over this code, so you're not able to see it. But for this is just a demo. Doesn't matter. This is not going to be how I end up making my final character. Oh, look how many eyes there are. Look at that. Oh, what derpy eye is that? Yeah, look at that. It's very resolute. You just look into the eyes and you can feel the soul of the character. I mean, this is the Shepherd I'm talking about. Wingspan Shepherd, who did such brave acts as punch reporters in the face and let all her crewmates die in the suicide mission. All kinds of... What the hell? No one's eyes look like that. Let's see. Where's those cold, dead eyes? No, I love you, honey. Yeah, there we go. Eyes like that. You can choose a neck thickness. I don't... Why? They give you every option. Now, I gotta say, when I played, what was that game? Fallout 3. That game was the most disappointing character creation I've seen in a game. I mean, no matter what, I get it, it's a nuclear apocalypse. No one's gonna look like Model of the Year. But the characters, I just felt like none of the options actually did anything. Oh, there's cheekbones. I just feel like no matter what you did, your character just looked like they got, like, shitted out of some alien's ass. So, right off the bat, this is just way, way better. Yeah, the shadows are still a little shaky. Fine, I get it. This is Xbox 360. I'm not really expecting world-class stuff here. We got different haircuts. Ooh, look at that. It's got that, like, sexy algebra teacher thing going on. Oh, I love it. Change the eyebrows to match. She's got some hair clipping through her head. I don't know, maybe that's just a cool hairstyle in the future. And let's get that, ooh, yeah, Ms. Reynolds, you are always the hottest. Alright, and let's see, your horror makeup, why do they give you makeup? Are people really doing this kind of makeup still in the future? Like, you're hardened, you're on the front lines of battle, alright? It's like, oh shit, the Reapers are coming, the Geth are coming, the Cerberus are coming, everyone's coming. And you're, hold on guys, I gotta put on my lipstick, so... I don't really get it. Alright, so the classes are still the same. Looks like most of these powers are still pretty much the same. It's previous Mass Effect 2. Sentinel still got his tech armor. Vanguard still got the charge. We see on the right, there's a nice little graph showing you. Alright, so you got a lot of muscle enhancements. You got a lot of mind enhancements. You got a lot of tech enhancements. And here we go. Were you born in space? Were you born on Earth? Were you born on a colony? I still don't really get what this... I guess this is how closely are you tied to Earth? Well, just like in real life, I could take it or leave it. And then what's your, like, personal background? I don't like to think of my Shepherd as some kind of hero, some kind of exceptional person. I like to think, sole survivor, Shepherd survived through dumb luck, some missile hit her colony, and somehow she's the only one that didn't get caught in the blast and died. So everyone else died, she lived, she's got survivor's guilt. who died in the previous ones. Everyone died. Everyone knows that Mass Effect, at the end of Mass Effect 2, you go on the suicide mission, and just everyone dies uncontrollably. There's nothing you can do about it. Everyone, it was a bloodbath. It was really terrible. So Morden, my man, I'm really sorry to let you die. Garrus, sorry to let you die. Thane, you kind of had it coming. I mean, you had a terminal disease anyway, so I don't really see what the point is of trying to save you. And here we go, guys. Mass Effect 3, the demo. And it's looking like we're just going to jump right into main story. How bad is it?
We just lost contact with two of our deep space outposts.
So,
there's something massive on the long range.
There's something massive. It's the Reapers, dummies.
Is this what Shepard warned us about?
Yes. Yes, it is. What I don't get about it is, how come no one believes Shepard? They're like, we don't believe you, Shepard. Only you've seen it. Don't they have video recorders in the future? I've got an Omni tool. My fucking cell phone right now can record at 1080p. You're telling me Shepard's going to fight the Reapers, and at the end of Mass Effect 2, he didn't hit record this shit? Record it in 3D holograms? He didn't press the record button and just record it so that everyone could just believe him. And everyone's like, oh, Shepard, it's great, but you just have, you know, we just don't believe you that there's giant creatures coming that... We don't believe that you went through the Omega-3 relay. All right, whatever. Was it the Omega-3 relay, or am I thinking about the fatty acids in salmon? I don't remember. All right.